Career variant we assign to the company code. Now coming to the posting periods. So, but before that, you must have idea on this. We should know the account type. So what is account type? Account type is nothing but just we are replacing the accounting terminology with some machine language or some technical language. Like in your day-to-day accounting, you are using customer, vendor, asset, then material, ledger. These are some account types are these are some terminologies are there which we are using in system. There is nothing called customer. So technically we are defining customer, or it is defined with, this is universally accepted, D, vendor K, asset A, material M, and ledger S. So why these account types are required? Because for example, you have two type of requirement. First of all, why we need to maintain these posting periods? Posting period, for example, let me show you first the user part, then I will configure this one. I'm trying to post one transaction in this company code. Check the message, posting period 5/2018, not open. Now what is posting period 5? That means January, if it is January to December, that is fifth posting period, that is May. That means being user or as an user, I can't post any transaction in the May. The reason is this period is not yet opened. So what is the concept of open and close? If any user can able to post the transaction, so that means user that period is open. If user not able to post the transaction, that period is closed. So we are going to define one variant, posting period variant, and using that posting period variant, we will control the users so that no one can post the transaction in close period. So close period means right now we will open the current period May and rest all the previous month and future months. Everything we are going to close it so that no posting in the previous month or backdated posting, no future dated postings will be there. But for example, we don't have this account types are there. It is only one option is there. And for company code, it is, let's say we have assigned, right? We don't have something called account type. But in real case, you will find sometimes we have some backlogs and we have to open simultaneously two periods. For example, let's say 2 days required from April, 2 days, like we have, let's say it is on 1st May, we supposed to close the period related to April or fourth period, and we have to open the May, that is the fifth period. But let's say this related to customer collection and all, it's not yet completed, the closing activity not yet done. So management want simultaneously for 2 days, both the periods should be open. That means period 4 and period 5, but not for all transaction, only for customer. So that means in this case, we will open the period here, April and May for customer, but others only May. So that's why we need the multiple account types, because same rule is not applicable for all the transactions in the company code. So that's why we have the account type is there. And in account type, another option you will find that is valid for all, which is plus. Transaction wise, there is nothing called plus is there, or document wise, we are not going to post any document related to plus, but plus is a second level control. Okay, so what is the use of plus? once I will configure, I will show you why we need a plus. Because in this, it is understood that means individual account types are there just to control the related transactions. Then why the plus is there? So that's why, even if in training system, if we'll only configure plus, it will work. We don't need the individual account types, because plus is going to control all the account types, so it is not required. But if we are going to maintain a different rule for a customer, different rule for vendor, different rule, then we need the individual account type. So it's better to have the individual account type along with plus. But before this, I have to create two posting period variant. One we will assign to the company code, and another one we will use it for non-leading ledger. And this posting period variant is defined with 4-digit code. So I'm going to take WM10 and WM20, but don't confuse, this is company code. This is not company code. I'm just using the same characters what I already used in the company code. It's a different one. So go to the transaction code OBBO, or from navigation it is related to fiscal year variant, global setting, then ledgers, fiscal year and posting periods, maintain fiscal year variant, already done. Next, where is posting period? Posting periods, define variant for open posting periods, new entry, new entry. See here, it's a different table. So that means this data we are going to maintain in T010 O table. Company code is T001. So don't confuse. Maximum time people think that this is company code we are using. No, it's not company code. I'm just using the same character. WM10 posting period variant leading, WM20 posting period variant non-leading. Save. Next, as it is created at client level, again you need to assign to the company code also. Assign variant to company code. Search your company code. And variant is WM10, not WM20, WM10. That is the, we are in, because under this variant we are going to maintain the calendar year, and WM20 we will maintain the non-calendar. So first we define a fiscal year variant. Under this fiscal year variant, or linked with this fiscal year variant, just to control the transactions or the periods, we have maintained one posting period variant. So then we assign this posting variant to company code. Now coming to the third step, open and close posting periods, OB52. That means in current, let's say we are going to follow the current year on current month only. That means we will only open the May, and rest all periods should be closed. Click on new entry, select the variant. So your variant is WM10. Select the account type. Let's say it is related to GL. Here, from account to account. From account to account means, let's say in the organization, 500 ledgers are there. This is the account, right? Related to account, ledger is account type ledger. So 500 accounts are there. Then maybe we will take here one, and we will take 500. That means whatever the rule we are defining, it is applicable to 500 ledgers only. After some, like next month, after the go live, let's say they added 20 more ledgers, more master records, more accounts. That means here also we need to change it, the settings. After 1 month, they added 5 more accounts. because as for the business transaction or requirement, the accounts will keep on increasing. So that's why we are not going to specify here any accounts. That means the upper limit and the lower, this lower limit and upper limit, we are not going to specify here. Rather, we will take infinite. Because maybe in one implementation, they are maintaining the account number, GL account number starting from one. In another implementation, they are going to start from 1000. So we are not going to specify here which account, because it's a common company, and that means general settings, and with multiple company code we can use it. So rather leave it blank. Blank means it is the starting. If they are going to start with one, it is applicable. If they are going to start with 5000 or 1000, that is also going to applicable. And in two, take the infinity. So you can take infinity times 9 or infinity times G. Both are okay. Period 1 from 2, period 2 from 2. Period 1 is for normal transactions, period 2 is for special transactions. Okay, that means I'm going to open the current month, so your period will be 5/2018, then 5/2018. Right now special periods is not applicable. Even if you will not maintain, there is no, it is not going to affect anyway. But if you want to maintain the special periods, so you can maintain the special periods what you want. So that means right now, with as for these settings, the normal transactions are applicable May, and special periods are also open. So when, how we can say open, it is open for May, that means from 5th to 5th, and 5th is our May posting period, right? So the current, suppose I want to maintain two posting periods at a time, so make it 4 to 5, so two periods are open. If it is like this, 1 to 5, January to May, all periods are open. This is for normal period, this is for special periods. Okay, so this is one monthly activity. That means once 31st May completed, before 1st June, user will start the work. This period should be 6, and it should be 6. Either you can go for manually, but practically nobody is going to do this manually. So it can be, they can create the, or we can through basis, we can develop one job and we can schedule the job automatically in one particular time. Automatically the period will be changed if you are going for automated. That means on 1st June midnight 12, automatically this will be changed, the period. So you can also prepare, or you can maintain the job also. Okay, so like this, you have to maintain for all the account types, right? What is the use of plus? Plus is going to control the individual account types, and plus is a second level control also. Now I think you can able to understand what is the use of plus. I'm going to show you in a different posting period variant where we can post the transaction. So basically the plus is mostly accessed by the consultant. It's not standardized. Maximum companies, they even completely, they assign this to their support consultants. Somewhere maybe these things are managed by power user, and this is with control to the consultants. And let's say, assume that it is managed with power users or user group. This is outside consultant. So check the settings. Now, current period is open at ledger level. Let's say I'm the user and I have the access to this one, and I opened both the period 4 and 5, both periods are open. But plus is I don't have the access. So at this level, only current period is open. That means individual account type at ledger level, S ledger level, both periods we open as we have some backlog, and at plus level, it is open by the consultant, only the current period. Now with these settings, I'm going to post a transaction in this company code, you check. I'm trying to post a backdated entry. April, this period also I changed. Posting period is 4. Selected some account. Check the message. Posting period 4/2018 not open. Whereas for 2018 fourth posting period, we have open at S level. So that means plus is going to override the settings, or we can say it is a second level control. If you want to open both the period, then it should be authorized by manager, and it should authorize at plus level also. So if I will open now at this level, then only it is going to work. Individually, if you're going to maintain account type level, it is not going to work. So that's why this plus is there, second level control. Now accept it. Okay, so that's why we have plus is there. Okay, cancel it. So one by one, you can add the posting period account, or better, we can copy from the standard. So copy line A, D, K, M, S, asset, customer, vendor, material, ledger. So this material, don't confuse, is related to material management. This match in material management, we have a separate posting period is there that we will configure when we will do the MM configuration. This line or this entry is there, whatever the integrated documents will be posted related to material. For example, you are posting a GL entry, some expense you are going to post. So what is the document type? What is the document is applicable? That is applicable something related to GL. If it is, let's say, GRIR document or something, let's say material consumption. Okay, so these things are not related directly to GL transaction. So these are related material document, because directly in system we are not going to post the transaction. So for that it is applicable. We'll get more clarity when we will do the configuration related to the integration. Okay, and also take the plus. Copy it.
If Pradeep, I'm a little confused about the plus. When you have the plus and you have the other account types, does plus override the other account types?
Yes, plus. Just now we have seen plus is going to override the other account types. Plus is second level control. Even if you'll,
you
while configuration,
you're assigning to a consultant. Okay. No, you said you assign it to a consultant.
No, normally this plus level, this line is managed by consultants who is responsible for support activity. And this one, these all is managed by individual users, power users. But it is not the like standardization, maybe completely assigned to the consultant. All this OB52 access is completely assigned to consultant. But some companies, they used to assign this one to consultant, which is outside business. And this is internal employee. So that's why second two level control is there.
Okay. Okay. All right.
Okay. Select all these lines, then change the variant. That means, for example, this 4, 5 is managed by in-house. This is managed by somebody outsider. So that we have a better control is there. Otherwise, if everything is managed by one internally, then they can change the period and they can post this transaction. But even maximum places, this is completely outside to the outside consultant. So they don't even give the access to OB52 to their users also. So it depends on organization to organization. Change the variant. WM10. And right now, if you'll only configure this plus, you can still practice in the system. This individual are not required, but individual required when you are going to take a different rule. For customer, different rule. For vendor, different rule. Then individual required. Okay, select it, then copy it. Now you can see in all account type, Z are there. That means infinity. Why not here? Even if you'll try to enter something, you will get the error. You click new entry, try here in plus level, you will get the error. Because it is not related to any transaction. It is going to control all the individual account type. So it should be blank. So open the current period. from period to period. Fiscal year variant, fiscal year. Save it. Okay, now copy all this. We have one more variant is there, WM20. Change it.
So if I only have plus configured, then I mean that means that
you can practice.
All the
you
periods are open at that point. They're not by account type. Is that right?
Yeah. You don't have an option to individually can maintain the account type. Plus means it. You can practice. You can post the transaction, but individually you can't maintain the transaction. You can. Sorry, you can't control. That means, as I told, for customer, you want to take a different rule. For GL, you want to take a different. That is not possible. Whatever the period you will open, that is applicable for all account type. Okay, if you'll go for non-calendar, then what should be the period? Second period. So it is created at what level? Client level. That means we define the posting period variant and we have assigned this posting period variant to company code, which one WM10, this 20 keep it reserve. In future, we are going to assign with non-leading ledger. That means in future, when we will post any transaction for non-leading ledger, if it is posted on month of May, then you will find for leading ledger transactions will be reported in fifth posting period, and for non-leading it will be there in second posting period, right? So that's why I'm just creating all the variants, additional one variant, so that in future I can use it for non-leading ledger. But right now, as per our current settings, this WM20 is not required. WM10, that is the calendar year settings, it is enough. Okay, so related to the fiscal year variant settings completed. Before going to here some changes are there in S4HANA. Okay, so right now in fiscal year variant, how many periods are you have? This is not related to you, this ECC, just for your update. Right now we are having period one, period two, and in S4 you will find period three also. Okay, that means if it is EC system, then two periods are there. If your implementation is on HANA system, then additionally one period will be there. So this is the concept same. This is normal period. This is special period. And this is for controlling. Same concept. This is related to controlling. That means right now in EC system, FI is separate, controlling is separate, two different modules. But in S4HANA system, controlling is part of your GL. So there is everything is part of GL. So that means we are going to load the data from controlling to GL, or we have a concept called universal general. So for example, you posted some transactions internally. Right now, it is I'm not sure whether you are getting the concept. If you know the concept of assessment or any month end distribution, so let's say period end any distributions we are doing here. Okay, initially we posted with a service department or some other department. Then in a month end, we are transferring this value to the production department. I think we discussed in this assessment. So I'm taking the same assessment exam. Okay, so assessment method, and this one we are doing in the month of June. We are doing this in month of June for the month of May. So it is internal, it is not going to affect our statutory reporting. So that's what we are doing right now. In ECC also we are doing the same thing, but whatever we are doing here in ECC, it is restricted only this part. It is not going to update in your FI. So that's why FI data is separate, CO data is separate, it will not match. Manually we are doing the reconciliation. Whereas in S4HANA, the manual reconciliations are not required because this data is going to update in your FI part, or we are saying that universal general. Okay, so for example, we posted one transaction initially, multiple ledgers are there, 50,000. We posted transaction FI entry. Okay, with cost center. ABC, this is FI entry. And again in controlling, we splitted this 50,000 to multiple cost centers. That's what we discussed. So this is my production cost centers P1. This is P2. And this is P3. So this data 50,000, we are going to change here. For this activity also we need the period, like in which period we have posted or in which period we are settling when we are going to execute the assessment program, you will find this one. So that's why we have this additional period is there. That's what we are going to do. We are going to load in S4HANA, we are going to load the data from CO to Universal Journal or to FI, you can say. So for this additional one period is open. For example, right now, what I told, in the month of June, we are going to do the settlement for the month of May. So that means your normal period is 06. What should be this period? If you are going to do the assessment for May, then make sure that this fifth period should be open. Then only we can do this. So in overall, we can say, briefly we can say, this period 3 we are maintaining to load the data from controlling to Universal Journal or from controlling to FI. Right now it is not required because right now we are keeping this data separate. Just at a glance, I'm going to show you the S4HANA system. That is the only change. That means conceptually this is the change, and configuration point of view, same way you are going to create the variant. You are going to assign the variant to the company code. Then additionally, you are going to maintain one period. That's it is required. Okay, just see here. Same configuration steps are same, everything is same, fiscal year and posting period variant. Same way you are going to maintain the fiscal year variant, same way you are going to maintain the posting period variant. Then you maintain the posting period variant. Okay. Then assign to the company code, then open and close posting periods. So add the posting period variant, whatever you configured. Let me show you one. Now you can see here, period 1 as usual, period 2 for special periods, period 3 we have maintained additionally. Okay, So right now, maybe in this company code, CO is not started. So that's why it is not maintained, but here it is required. So this period may be 5, but if you're doing the settlement for March or some period, then make sure that at plus level, so it should be open here 4 to 4, then only the data will be loaded in FI. Got it? Hello. This part is not relevant for you, just for your additional information I shared.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, so far, like all your configurations completed, whatever I configured, everything is done. No, you have not started system access. Khalil, Chintan, for you, it is done.
No, I haven't been able to, but I'm going to plan to do this week. So probably tonight, that's what I'm planning to do.
Rajesh, I think you have not yet started, I think.
Yeah, no, Pradeep, I haven't started.
Yes, I know. Okay, so next we are going to start with the document. So it will take time. We will start with the new, because it's a very important concept, not only for FI, also it is relevant for MM and ST. You complete your backlog and we'll continue with tomorrow. So we'll start.